They are stuffing these changes into the budget bill to avoid accountability. Yeah. But it won't work. New Democrats will hold them to account. Yeah. Madam Speaker, we created national parks to protect our natural heritage. But conservatives' changes will mean fewer reviews of park management plans and reduce the ability to keep up with changing conditions. On top of this, the minister is sending layoff notices to hundreds of park staff. Why is the minister ignoring his duty to protect Canada's natural spaces?
The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary to the Minister of Environment.
Well, Madam Speaker, my colleague opposite is quite right. Our government has done more to protect Canada's natural heritage and park space than any other government.
Sure has.
Madam Speaker, we've protected over 150,000 square kilometres of parklands, and we've funded these measures to ensure that they're sustainable. Budget measures my colleagues opposite voted against.
Why?
Madam Speaker, we'll continue to ensure that frontline services are provided and that visitors across this country can enjoy Canada's great natural heritage.
The Honourable Member for Nickel Belt.
Madam Speaker, what the Conservatives are ensuring is less access for Canadians and a decline of tourism dollars. Communities across Canada are slowly learning the details of the changes hidden in the Conservative budget bill. No more interpreters to connect visitors with our natural heritage. Shorter park seasons and hours slashed. Less ecological management and fewer tourist dollars for local businesses. Why is the minister cutting access to our public spaces and pulling money out of our local economies?
The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary to the Minister of Environment.
Well, Madam Speaker, tourism is certainly an important part of Canada's economy, and members of the tourism industry will tell you that during peak demand, you ramp up staff. What we're trying to do with Canada's parks is ensure that during peak demand times, Canada's parks are staffed by frontline services, that those services will continue to exist under our well-funded parks plan. Madam Speaker, I'd ask my colleague opposite to actually look at the budget bill and examine these changes in detail, which will continue to ensure that our parks are well-serviced and that Canadians can enjoy them for years to come.
The Honourable Member.
Member for Cape Breton Council.
Madam Speaker, perhaps my question should be directed at the Minister of Health. As the actions of this government really carved the heart out of a community in my riding. Cuts by Parks Canada to Lewisburg, St. Peter's, the Canso area. It's not only the 170 people that lost their jobs and their families, but it's those that depend on the tourism industry, and this will cripple the tourism industry. Hotel owners, campground owners, restaurant owners, Madam Speaker, they will feel the pain. These are reckless, senseless, stupid cuts. Why has this government turned its back on the national park system?
The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary to the Minister of Environment.
Well, Madam Speaker, I'd remind my colleague opposite that their government did not protect that much park space as we've done in the last 6 years. 150,000 square kilometres of parkland protected under our government. Furthermore, we provide support to Canada's parks through things like My Parks Pass system, tourism support systems for marketing and promotion, and we're going to ensure that frontline services continue to be provided in a very robust way during peak times.
Robust.
I certainly hope my colleague opposite will support these measures.
The Honourable Member for Cape Breton Council.
Madam Speaker, she pats herself on the back. You know, they opened up a new park, provided no new money for it. They have to take the operation of that park out of the existing programs, which will further impact negatively on the current park inventory. Right. But the question is, where are the Tory backbenchers when there's being cuts to their communities? Where's the minister from PEI who has jobs leaving the island like rats leaving the ship? Where's the member from Peterborough who's losing jobs? What about Stormont, Dundas, South Glengarry? 38...
Order, please. The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary to the Minister of Environment. I'm sure we all want to hear the answer.
Well, Madam Speaker, I believe it's unparliamentary to talk about where backbenchers are, so I won't mention where the backbenchers are in the Liberal Party today. Madam Speaker, I believe that our park system will continue.
I'm sorry. I would like to ask for little order in the House while the Parliamentary Secretary.
The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary. Madam Speaker, our government is committed to ensuring that our parks are well promoted and well visited. They're part of Canada's national brand. They're respected internationally around the world. And what we've put forward in the budget will ensure that the parks are well staffed during peak seasons for years to come. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
The Honourable Member for Vancouver-Narrabla.
The Honourable Member for Bois-Noir-Salaberry. Madam Speaker, after withdrawing Canada from the Kyoto Protocol, now the government is slashing environmental protection. Even more ridiculous, the Finance Committee is being asked to study the changes to the environmental assessment legislation. This is irresponsible. C-38 will have direct consequences for the approval of major oil projects. By speeding up approval and hurting the environment. Why are the Conservatives imposing closure rather than asking the Environment Committee to look at this?
Madam Speaker, in a survey commissioned by Ipsos Reid, two-thirds of Canadians agree that it is possible to increase oil and gas productions while protecting the environment at the same time. Balance. Balance between protecting the environment and creating economic growth, a principle the NDP has absolutely no conscience of. With our budget bill this year, Madam Speaker, we're going to ensure one project, one review, streamlined environmental assessments, and, Madam Speaker, we increased funding to the Canadian Environmental Assessment Act. I encourage my colleague opposite to read the budget.
The Honourable Member for Richmond Hill.